Today we're gonna build what in the past was considered a pretty futuristic technology. It's a clap switch. So basically you just clap to control your lights. All you need to do is just clap 2 times. And building such device nowadays is pretty easy. So stay tuned and let's get started. Hi humans, welcome to Electrical Project channel. To make this device work, we don't even need to solder anything. But we need some components, the most important is Arduino. Well, Arduino is the brain of the whole project. Arduino's job here is to recognize the correct clap pattern. 2 claps in our case. If it's just 1 clap, it's not gonna do anything. And the first what we have to do is to flash the Arduino. Link to the code you will find in the description. This is pretty simple, let's connect it to a computer. And flash it. After it's done, next what we have to do is to connect everything. Let's start with the microphone. So let's connect ground and 5 volts. The output of the microphone let's connect to the pin number 2. Now let's connect power to the relay. Let's connect ground pin first. And now let's connect 5 volts. But oh no, we have a problem, there is no more 5 volt pins here, and I need 5 volt. What should I do? Use a breadboard? Wrong, on Arduino IRF pin is the same pin as 5 volt. So let's just connect it here and keep this project simple. And now let's connect the input pin of the relay to the Arduino pin number 9. Now let's power up everything. Now we have to adjust the sensitivity of the microphone. If everything works properly, after 1 clap, Arduino should light up built-in LED for a short period of time. If you clap 2 times in sequence, the relay should switch. If it works, it means you can control any device. A light bulb, for example. Let's connect it. And be careful with the mains electricity, they say it can kill. And I think it's a bad idea to test that assumption, so let's just be safe. Now let's see how it works and test the device. As you can see, it recognizes the claps very well, but we still have a problem. The problem is that the microphone is sensitive to a wide range of sounds, including voice, which leads to false light switching.
Test. 1, 2, 3, test. Test, test, 1, 2, 3, test. Test, test, 1, 2, 3, test.
You can obviously decrease the sensitivity of the microphone in order to fix the problem. But then you will have to clap very loud, and you have to do this very close to the microphone, which is not very convenient. If only there was a way to fix that. And actually there is, but it's a bit advanced. In order to fix the problem, we need to understand the difference between clapping and voice sounds in terms of frequencies. The clapping sounds have high frequency components. So in order to fix the problem, we need to make this microphone module more sensitive to high frequencies and less sensitive to low frequencies. And that is what I'm going to do. The 100 nanofarad capacitor that is connected in parallel with the microphone we're gonna remove permanently. Another 100 nanofarad capacitor I'm gonna replace with 1 nanofarad capacitor, which gonna make this module less sensitive to low frequencies. So let's solder 1 nanofarad capacitor. If you don't have an SMD capacitor, you can just use a regular one. After cleaning, it looks perfect, so let's connect it back and test it. Let's adjust the sensitivity.
Voice detection test. Voice detection test. Clap detection test.
It works much better now, and it doesn't react to my voice. My assumption about frequency differences is correct. But there is still one more capacitor that can be removed to increase response to higher frequencies. So let's remove it. Now let's test it.
Voice detection test. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, test. Test.
Now it's perfect, it's not sensitive even to a loud voice, but sensitive to clapping. I'm very satisfied with the results. As always, the code can be improved, but it's already good. It has some false triggering prevention. Let me demonstrate. And that's it! Links to all of the components for this project you can find in the description to this video. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one!